Hi, it's Corinne. Thanks so much for stopping by. Today I am making Christmas cards. I just received the Festive Blooms by Concord and Ninth, and this die set has quickly become one of my favorites. This is so easy to put together. It looks so intricate, and I really believe the recipient will really enjoy a card like this. So here I'm just showing you the die set used, Festive Blooms dies. And I started out just to make a couple, but I quickly was enjoying the process so much, I just die cut a bunch of different cardstocks. I wanted to use up some glitter cardstock that I've had in my stash for a long time. The rest of it is going to be all Concord and Ninth. I pulled out my swatch cardstock from Concord and Ninth and some ink blending brushes along with some distress inks. And like I said, I just cut a bunch of die cuts out. I did also cut a bunch of the large flower and the medium flower from white cardstock because I did double those. So here's the main back piece. I cut a sample piece because it's a good thing to reference when you're first putting this together because it shows you where everything goes. So here are the dies, and each one of those that I cut that you see, I did also double. I put a piece of white cardstock behind it just to give it a little bulk and sturdiness. So for the one I'm putting together on screen, that is the rose gold foil cardstock. I have some silver matte cardstock. I have some Concord and Ninth Sweet Pea with a little ink blending, some Briar Rose from Concord and Ninth, and I believe I used Grasshopper for the greens, Grasshopper and Avocado. If you'd like me to double check the colors, I can double check those for you, but I'm pretty sure the lighter one is Grasshopper. So for my back piece, I'm using some pink glitter cardstock that I've had in my stash a long time. I'm layering some pink glitter cardstock on top of the rose gold foil cardstock. That's such a pretty cardstock. That's by Concord and Ninth. Their matte gold is super pretty as well. So I'm referring to my reference piece. After you put two of these together, you really don't even need to refer to that, but I was kind of using that as a guide as far as how to put my flowers on. And truthfully, you don't even have to follow that guide. That stitching detail in the back is so pretty. It would look really pretty showing through if you wanted to not do all of them or just do them differently. Me personally, I just followed the guides because it turned out so pretty, I figured why change it up. Same with, as you may have seen in the photos, it comes with a banner die. It also comes with stamps. I did not get the stamps and I was regretting that a little bit, but I just went through my stamps that I had and I found quite a few that went well with this style card and with the banner itself. But I didn't plan on using the banner on all of them because it does cover up a portion of the card. I decided, you know, I had to try the banner for a couple of cards and I figured I would do something different for the rest of them, just like maybe a smaller greeting or no greeting on the front of it, just put my greeting on the inside. But the banner looks so pretty, I ended up doing it for all of them, which I'll show later in the process. I heat embossed on each one of the banners and put a banner on each one of these cards. It was just too pretty. So as you can see, I'm just following that guide using some wet glue. I'm using some Barely Arts glue in a fine tip bottle. And as I glue things down, I just put a paperweight on them, let them dry for a few minutes as I'm working on a different portion of the card. So I think I ended up making 15 cards, like I may have mentioned. I think I made 15 cards. I did this over probably a week's worth of time. I would just come in my craft room, put a few more together. This was a really fun process, and I absolutely love how the cards turned out. So I used the centerpiece for the flowers that comes in the die set. You could put jewels if you wanted to, which I think would be really pretty, but I really like the centerpiece. And if you just kind of turn it, it's like a puzzle piece. It just kind of falls into place. So just turn your flower and you'll see how it goes on there. So for these little berries, I'm using some Sweet Pea cardstock by Concord and Ninth, and I'm using my jewel picker. That's helpful to get things into place. Some reverse tweezers, jewel picker, and some paperweights are really helpful with this card. So here's a little close up. And like I mentioned, I'm not sure if I did it on this one actually, but I did all those large flowers, I did back with a white piece of cardstock just to give them a little bit of thickness and dimension. I did make one card where I doubled all of the die cuts, but I did not think that was necessary. To me, it's a waste of cardstock and a waste of time. So for all the flowers, the two larger flowers and the two smaller flowers, I did use some foam dots in the back and some wet glue. That way it just helps them stand up. And I'm using some clamps and reverse tweezers to give those a chance to dry. So for the larger flowers, I just add the wet glue to the inside. And then as you can see, all the petals have just a small piece of foam dot. I have a large roll of foam dots and I just cut a bunch down ahead of time, put them in a little dish, and they were easy to work with. This is where I was using my sample to just kind of see how the flower goes on. Like I said, that's not necessary. You don't have to follow it perfectly. And after the second card, you know exactly where everything goes. Probably after the first card, I was pretty familiar with how it goes. It takes all the guesswork out for you. I was just trying to figure out which way the flower goes. And like I said, twice already, it really does not matter, but I did want to follow it at first just to see how it was intended to look. So all my card bases are 4.25 by 5.5 standard A2 sized cards, and all the matte pieces, like the one I'm doing here, are going to be different. I think I only made two cards the same, or maybe I made two style of cards twice. Besides that, I did something different on all of them. So this one, I used the matte silver foil in the back, added some Beacon Fabri-Tac glue, used my scoreboard to help me get that in the corner lined up. And I'm just kind of bending all the flowers just to give them some lift. And again, I used my Beacon Fabri-Tac, really pressed that down and set that aside to dry. It's that simple. These were so much fun to make. And the banner does cover up those little berries in the middle. Like I said, I had no intention. I might make another couple of cards with no banner just because it's so pretty on its own. But here's the banner die. This is a template, essentially. I cut out the banner die, as you can see, four times there. I have a sticky mat in the back, and I'm treating each one of those pieces with some anti-static powder. I'm using my Versamark ink and just different sentiments. I just did a bunch. Again, just wanted to use different ones, have options. Some I embossed with silver embossing powder, some I did with white, and then I did some in platinum gold, I believe. I have quite a few left over, so I can use them on other cards or these cards in the future. But I just heat embossed each one of these, wiped them off with a microfiber towel, and now I have quite a few to choose from. Probably my favorite is the rose gold cardstock. So I went through, picked out a banner for each one, and then just went through assembly line style and glued each one. I'm showing you a close-up. You can do this banner, the banner pieces, however you want. You can use a little bit darker cardstock so it stands out a little bit more. You can ink blend them. I'm sorry I'm a little off frame right there, but you just glue it towards the end of it and it gives it such a pretty banner look. So I would go through, let those dry, and then put a foam square underneath it to keep the lift of it. So pretty. I did wet glue on the sides of it. And then I have a bunch of clamps from the Dollar Tree. Those are great. Those work great. So I just clamped them off, set them aside, worked on the next one. So here are the rest of the cards. Like I said, I believe I did like 15 of them. Most of them are on a white card base. I did make one with a red card base using cranberry cardstock from Concord and Ninth, but that really is just a waste of the cardstock. It looks good on a white card base. You just cut the front panel off instead. So here I'm talking you through the process, but I'm doing a voiceover, so my hands may not match what I'm saying, but I lost the footage from that, so I wanted to just voice it over. I'm just showing you here that I did ink embossing on each one of those banners, and the gold, the foil paper from Concord and Ninth really does emboss well. And if you get a little extra glue, just use a little wet wipe and it'll clean it off. This one I used pink glitter background. This is actually the one I made on camera now that I see it. So you saw me just make this one. I used Sweet Pea, that matte silver foil, pink glitter cardstock. I had so much fun with this. And then I love the pop of green. Here's the white card base. I used a 110 pound hammer mill, so it's got a nice sturdiness to it. And here I'm showing that I popped all of those out on foam dots. Rewatching this video, it makes me want to, I made these last over the last probably 2 weeks, but it does make me want to go make a couple more of these cards. And maybe without the banner this time. I don't know if I can stop myself or not, because that banner is so pretty. I can look up those specific colors, but as I mentioned earlier, I think it was Grasshopper and Avocado from Concord and Ninth. I ink blended the center of some of the flowers, and that layer piece on the smaller flowers, on some of them, like this one, you probably can't see it in camera, but I did ink blend them to show a little bit of a difference between the layering piece and the back of the flower, but it's really hard to pick up on camera. There will be some cards that you'll be able to see what I'm talking about. And here I'm just pointing out the fact that I did put a foam piece behind it to give it that dimension there to make it stand up on the right side. So for this one, I used more pink glitter cardstock. I think I did 4 cards with that pink. I liked being able to use that up from my stash. I used some silver cardstock from my stash. The red that you see throughout is cranberry from Concord and Ninth. I used up all, I think I have one tiny scrap left. I had to order some more of that, the matte gold and the rose gold. So this one I used, I thought this was a little different. I thought I would try it. I used black glitter cardstock combined with the rose gold, the cranberry, and some pink glitter cardstock. This is red foil. The background piece is red foil from Concord and Ninth, mixed with pinks. I do like pink and reds for Christmas. This is probably my favorite. I believe I made 2 of these color schemes. I believe that's eucalyptus from Concord and Ninth. The yellow or the ivory color that you see of the small flowers is actually just from my stash. I don't even know. It could be Nina brand now that I think about it, but I did ink blend the center of it with some Buttercup from Concord and Ninth. This one I used gold, same with that gold matte and gold embossing. This one's so pretty. Like I mentioned, I love that color scheme, but I did different sentiments. I love how the joy to the world turned out. This one has that gold with some pink. Here's where you can see the ink blending on the top layer of the flower. It shows pretty well right there. So that just made it stand out a little bit from the back of the flower. This one I did golds and again that cranberry. This is another really pretty one. I used Briar Rose with some white flowers. Used that rose gold in the back. For my very back matting piece, I used pink glitter cardstock. I've had a lot of that cardstock in my stash for quite a while. So like I've said probably twice, I really enjoyed using it. This I used, I believe it's the eucalyptus, where I ink blended the layering piece. I love this pink and red. I used silver glitter for the leaves in that one. And then this one, mixing the gold with the rose gold and the pink glitter, so pretty. Here I'm just showing you that I did double that back piece to give it dimension on all of them. This one I used a blueberry because I wanted to try a blue Christmas scheme, blue with the red, and I used the Merry Christmas for the banner. These last two are similar, they're gold and red, and one of them I put on the cranberry card base, but like I said, that's really a waste of cardstock. Just put it on a white card base and it looks just the same. So I really hope you've enjoyed this process. Thank you so much for stopping by. And if you've not tried this die set from Concord and Ninth, it is a little bit pricier, but I understand why. You really get a lot of dies with it and all the work is already done for you. So if you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments and let me know what you think. Thank you so much for stopping by. I hope you'll subscribe to my channel and have a great day.